To you by Phillips Milk of Magnesia, the gentle laxative for the whole family, regular or mint flavor. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, star of television and the Broadway stage, always a welcome guest panelist, Miss Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. It's my pleasure tonight to welcome to What's My Line a very talented young comedian. You've seen him on many shows on television, and he and I have had the pleasure of working together on a late night one. Mr. Dick Cavett.
When I used to watch this show as a boy, the lady on my left was always introduced, when I was watching from Nebraska, as brilliant, charming, vivacious, and lovely. And I find tonight that she's also friendly, the loveliest star of Dinner at Eight, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now, one of the reasons that we have thoroughly enjoyed 17 years of happiness on What's My Line is our next panelist, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And here is our moderator, a man known in some extremely eccentric circles as Silent John Daly.
You can't frighten me into silence, Bennett Cerf. I don't frighten that easily. Miss Phyllis, it's nice to see you again on our panel.
Thank you.
And Dick, nice to welcome you to the panel. Hope you enjoy the next half hour. Actually, for Arlene and Bennett, my good old friends of all these years, we're changing the rules a bit tonight, so get your blindfolds ready. We're going to play some extra games, extra tricks on you tonight. We're going to have not only one mystery challenger, we're going to have two challenges. So if you would please put on your masks. We'll get forward with this business that we're up to here. We also have an occupation, too, to puzzle you, but we're going to start off with a mystery challenger. Are the blindfolds all in place?
Yes, sir.
All right, then will our first mystery challenger enter and sign in, please. Panel, as you know, in the Mystic Challenges, we use the other form of questioning, one question at a time in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin with Bennett Cerf.
Well, you've got a great round of applause, which I trust you merit. If you were asked, are you in the entertainment business, would you answer yes?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
Well, your voice is a girl's, but there were no whistles, so are you a man?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Mr. Cavett. Hmm.
Trying to think what that leaves. I assume that you are in the performing end of entertainment business, is that correct?
Yes.
Now, I would, with our guest's permission, note that that's a very broad statement you made, and we have given you the yes in the broad context. All right, Miss Francis?
Broad statement. You mean, I'm sorry, John, I didn't quite understand. You mean as a performer in the entertainment business?
The question was that we can assume you are a performer in the entertainment business, and we said yes, but it's in a broad context that we so did.
There was a prolonged applause on the entrance. Is there possibly more than one there?
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Are you a girl or a pussycat? I didn't mean that as a question.
I won't count it as a question. Bennett, I'm feeling very generous tonight.
I know you. Very confusing, too. Do you do something that elicits applause from a live audience?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Miss Newman.
Well, now, people know you, and do you appear on television, either performing or doing something else?
Sometimes.
Mr. Cavett?
This is a stab in the dark. Are you by any chance the voice of the cuckoo on the razor blade commercials?
No.
That's four down and six to go, Miss Friend.
I really don't know whether we have established whether is our mystery guest a personality best known for radio or television?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, then, do you sing, dance, or possibly write something?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
You sing, dance, or write something, did you say, Bennett?
That was right.
Mm-hmm. Well, do you write or talk?
Yes.
Mr. Cavett?
You write or talk, or none of the above. Let's see.
Oh!
You write or talk. Do you do this primarily in one medium as opposed to another, or do you do it in more than one medium? In other words, do you do it in more than one medium?
Yes. Hello?
That's Miss Francis.
Is this lady a writer who forced gentlemen to prefer blondes? Is it Anita Luce?
No!
Go, Bennett.
Is this a lady who has ever been a member of this particular panel?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
Oh, my heavens, I can't remember. I'll say something just out. Are you, did you write Sex and the Single Girl?
No.
Seven, down, and three to go.
Write Sex and the Married Girl.
Did you read Sex and the Single Girl? Sorry. Is that my turn?
Yes, your turn. Still.
Are you a playwright ever?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Arlene Francis.
If I haven't got it now, I'm going to kill myself. Is this the lady that is just as pretty as all the ladies she writes about in Suzy Says?
Yes. It is indeed.
The unstumpable Arlene Francis.
Well,
you do look like a pussycat, isn't you right?
But Suzy, we did very well. You see where we got? Eight
isn't
down and
marvelous?
Two to go. That
I'm
was,
so
that
thrilled.
Was
I didn't
fun.
Know whether I could disguise my voice
Let's
enough because you all know it
again.
So well.
Let's hear that pussycat voice again.
Meow.
This is Mehle. Right?
Yes, Mr. Sir.
Mrs. Mehle. How many is King's Features? How many newspapers, Suzy?
About 60.
About 60. That's an awful lot of newspapers. And then we're lucky enough to have you very often on What's
Well. And one of the best columnists we have. Too.
Thank you, Arlene. Thank you so much. This is fun. This side is fun.
We're going to write a novel someday, too, if we can have a pin or down.
That's right. That's right, Bennett.
I'm sorry about the razor blade remark.
Not at all. I liked it.
Well, you were cutting pretty close, I thought. And there we are. Well, thanks. Thanks very much, Suzy.
Thank
See you again very soon. Huh? We'll have another contestant for you in just a moment after this word.
Come in.
Night, Mom. Hope you feel better tomorrow.
Oh, I think I will.
If you're one of the millions of people who sometimes rely on a laxative, listen to this. Phillips Milk of Magnesia is the kind of laxative doctors recommend. When thousands of doctors across the country were asked, "Do you ever recommend Milk of Magnesia?" the overwhelming majority said they did. Phillips Milk of Magnesia does more for you because it's a laxative plus an antacid. As a laxative, Phillips works thoroughly but gently for truly comfortable relief. As an antacid, Phillips relieves the acid stomach troubles which often accompany irregularity. No single-purpose laxative can give such complete yet gentle relief. Remember, doctors recommend Milk of Magnesia. So if you're one of the millions who sometimes rely on a laxative, take Phillips Milk of Magnesia, now also in mint-flavored form.
And now to meet a regular contestant, will you enter and sign in, please? Sharon Kusarek, right? And is it Miss or Mrs. Kusarek?
Miss.
Miss Kusarek, and where are you from?
From Omaha, Nebraska.
Omaha, Nebraska. It's very nice to have you with us. Miss Kusarek, may I present the panel? Now, would you join me over here, please? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Ms. Kusarek is salaried and deals in a product, and we'll begin the general questioning with Phyllis Newman.
Thank you. Ms. Kusarek, is this product something that I might use?
Yes.
If I used it, would it help me in any way?
No, not really.
It wouldn't help me.
Not in the accepted sense of help. If you used it, you would not...
It wouldn't be beneficial in any way to me.
Not in the substantive terms that I think would be implied by the use of the word help.
It would serve a useful purpose
for your needs, but unfortunately, that's one down and nine to
just
go.
Just meant no.
Yeah, that's right. Mr. Cavett?
The trick is to get a yes. Let's see. Would I not be incorrect in anticipating a negative answer to an affirmatively stated question as to whether I might use this product?
I don't know.
You can play at your game, Daly. Would I be likely to use this product?
Yes.
I see. Is it possible that I have one of these in my home at the moment?
Yeah.
Could.
Possible.
You could.
Mm-hmm. Is it something that I might be able to purchase in a department store like Macy's?
Yes.
Would it be unusual to give one of these as a wedding present?
Yes. That's two down and eight to go, Miss French.
Does this product come in contact with the body in any way?
Yes.
Would it be considered apparel in any sense of the word?
No, I don't think we could call it apparel. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Ms. Kusarek, when this object does come in contact with the body, would passers-by be able to see it?
Yes.
They would. In other words, it's on the outside of the person.
Yes.
Yes.
Is this product found above the waist?
Yes.
Is it above the neck?
Yes.
Is it below the hairline?
Yes.
Is it above the mouth?
Sometimes.
Now we're in trouble. Sometimes. Right.
Well, then it's in the general area between the eyes and underneath the mouth. Is that correct?
Yes.
And it would be visible.
Yes.
Is there any powder or liquid in this product?
No.
No powder, no liquid. Four down and six to go, Miss Newman.
Is it something that you can put on your face?
Yes.
Is it anything in the mask family?
Yes.
Is it a Halloween mask or mask like that?
Very good. There's just a small matter of what does Miss Kusarek have to do with Halloween masks?
You make or sell them?
Make is right. We got to give you all the bottles and turn all the marbles over all at the same time. Miss Kusarek, is with Austin Art Studio,
yes.
Right, in Omaha. And that's all she works on, is the plastic mist and the plastic mask.
Plastic and gauze.
It's a seasonal job, isn't it?
No, no.
I mean, you're making them all year round?
All for one day.
All for one day.
No. And I don't think you'd mind. Can I announce, too, that Miss Kusarek is going to celebrate Halloween properly this year? She's going to get married next Saturday. Yeah. And while a whole Austin Art Studio celebrates with you, you can also think we'll be thinking of you, too,
okay,
and wish
thanks.
You much happiness and a long and very, very full life.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Nice to see you. We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this message.
It's at moments like this, when so much is at stake, that full power acceleration really counts. And here's proof that under conditions of full power acceleration, the brand of spark plugs really makes a difference. In tests sanctioned by the United States Auto Club, 46 out of 50 Cadillacs accelerated faster with Champions. Here is an actual test. This Cadillac is using the brand of plugs that originally come in Cadillacs. The white one uses Champions. Both sets of plugs were new. An electronic starter throws both throttles wide open simultaneously. No human element is involved. All the driver does is steer. After only 200 yards, the white car with Champion plugs is clearly ahead. Now we switch brands. This time the other one gets Champions. Both start simultaneously. And again, the Cadillac with Champion spark plugs wins easily. For full power acceleration, insist on Champion spark plugs.
And now another special feature in tonight's program, the appearance of our second mystery guest, for which, as always, the panel must be blindfolded. Are the blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes.
Good. Will you enter, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Just a gentle reminder, once again, we revert to the mystery challenger form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. We'll begin with Arlene Francis.
Are you used to appearing before audiences?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Was that a yes?
That was a yes.
I thought the wolf whistles meant a girl, but this sounds like a male to me. Are you a male?
Yes.
Miss Newman?
If I were lucky enough to appear in a movie with you, would you get me at the end?
But I think for what you're...
I meant the hero, you know, who gets the girl type.
Well, I think we would be unfair if we would suggest that in the basic term of reference, we were talking about the hero who would always get the young girl. So we'll give you a no. One down and nine to go, Mr. Cavett.
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure it's been established that you are in the entertainment business. You are in the entertainment business?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Do you ever sing?
No. That was a no. That's two down and eight to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, when you are engaged in television, do you appear before the public?
Yes.
That makes Miss Newman next.
Are you seen more in movies than in television?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Cavett.
I just had a terrible feeling that the guest is sitting there wondering who I am. Is part of your profession to intentionally make people laugh?
No.
That's four down and six to go. We'll give you a no on that with a question mark after it. Miss Francis.
Well, that's a very big point. That means we do not consider our guest a comedian. Is that correct?
That would be correct, yes.
Are you in a series?
No.
What? No. Don't crack my head off.
No, no.
But now, how do you mean a series? Describe.
Do you appear regularly?
Yes.
Mr. Sir.
I have a feeling. Do you appear regularly in this very theater that we are broadcasting this panel show from tonight?
Yes.
Miss Newman.
Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan?
Yeah. One thing I must say, you know, the real pleasure that I get out of seeing Ed is he's the only man of whom we may all say he's older than we are. 19 years.
Yes.
19 years, right? You're in your 19th year, and we're going into our 18th year pretty soon.
What
he's older
voice.
Than we are.
That really fooled us. That voice was terrific.
Now, wasn't that good? Yeah. You've been going to, what was it you went to?
You're going up to Yonkers now.
You're going up to Yonkers
so
now.
So then I have got a real good thing running.
That's yeah, what she told me.
I don't understand what you're talking about, Mr. Sullivan. Really? No, I'm just kidding. No, I was teasing you about you going to school and taking singing lessons.
Oh, no.
John, yeah. What Ed never tells the public is one of the great things about him is that Mrs. Ed Sullivan went to public school 10 Manhattan, which is the school Dick Rogers and I went to, and we love her very much.
And you have the most active alumni body, I would guess, of any public school.
He has.
Most active alumni. But doesn't PS 10 have a very active alumni body?
We got Mayor Lindsay up there the other day to put a plaque on the site of the school.
They were also surprised they got out. They go back again and again and again to make sure it really happened.
We're not sure we graduated.
We're not sure we graduated. Well, you did a long time ago. Bless you, Ed, for taking time out and giving
John,
it to
John, it's so very, very nice to see you
good
again.
Good to see you again,
always
sire.
Watch
thank
you all the time and love it.
Thank
Bye.
You. Well, on points panel, I got to say you've done rather well so far tonight. And we'll have another contestant after this word.
Nothing's as brittle as a potato chip. Yet new soft Blue Bonnet margarine is so soft, it even spreads on a brittle potato chip without breaking it. You get famous Blue Bonnet flavor, and it's low in saturated fat. Spreads smoother, easier. Blue Bonnet looks like, cooks like, tastes like the high price spread. Soft or regular.
Everything's better with Blue Bonnet on it.
A new invention from Royal. It's called baking.
Baking?
In your refrigerator with the new Royal No-Bakes. Each complete with crumbs for crust and a fabulous filling mix. Just chill 1 hour.
Mmm, great cheesecake.
Dutch chocolate pie. Nestle Road Pie. The fabulous No-Bakes from Royal.
And now to meet a final contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Pat? Pat Carlson, right, ma'am? Miss or Mrs. Carlson?
Mrs.
Mrs. Carlson, where are you from?
I'm from a village near Oxford in England.
Oh, that's a long way to come. Nice of you to come that far. May I present our panel, Mrs. Carlson?
From where, John?
A village near Oxford in England. Now, would you join me over here, please, ma'am, and we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Carlson is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll begin the questioning with Mr. Cavett.
Ah. May I ask you, is this something, the service that I might have encountered?
It could be.
Mm-hmm. Is it something that would be considered uncommon for a woman to encounter?
It could be.
Could be. Is there physical contact involved in this service?
You mean with another person?
No, between you and the person who avails himself of the service?
No. That's one down and nine to go. Arlene.
Mrs. Carlson, does your job require any dexterity of any kind?
Yes.
Physical dexterity?
Yes.
Does it have anything to do with sports or physical education?
Yes.
Is it sports?
Yes.
Do you play any of the games that are famous in your country, England?
No.
Two down and eight to go. Bennett, sir.
But you do, Miss Carlson, you do not play a game that's famous in England, you say?
No.
But do you indulge yourself in some game?
No.
Oh, you don't?
That's three down and seven to go, Miss Newman.
You don't indulge in the game, but you're connected with this game in some way.
Now, you are here presuming
connected
something.
Connected with a sport in some way.
The issue that has been clarified is that Mrs. Carlson is connected with sport. They then went particularly to the game as a part
I
of the
see.
Sport world,
as,
and that's been ruled
out. As part
of
this sport, might I come and see you in connection with this sport?
You might.
Do you involve yourself with another person in this sport?
Yes.
Do you have physical contact with this other person?
Generally, no.
No. It should not be. It should not be. Mr. Cavett,
Is part of the sport to avoid physical contact with the person?
Yeah. Well, let's say it's desirable, but it's not a part of it. So that's five down and five to go, Miss Francis.
Rather than being actively associated in the sport yourself, are you something of a trainer or umpire or something? No.
Six down and four to go. Bennett, you want to take a shot? We're running out of time.
Well, may I eliminate the raffle that goes on in England? The taking numbers, betting on numbers?
No, boxing or wrestling?
Boxing? Is it fisticuffs?
No.
Karate.
An automobile racing champion.
Oh!
Mrs. Carlson is with the Saab Auto Company of Sweden, as is Mr. Carlson, and she's the sister of the great Sterling Moss, who is one of the great drivers.
Indeed.
And we thank you very much for driving to see us today. Nice to see you. Dick Cavett and Phyllis, lovely to have you with us, and good night, Miss Newman.
Thank you. Good night, and good night, Dick.
Good night, Phyllis, and good night, Miss Francis.
Good
it
night.
Was a pleasure.
Thank you, Dick. Good night, Bennett, dear.
John, you haven't got one of those masks on, have you, tonight?
That is all. Good night, Bennett Cerf, and thanks to all of you for being with us on What's My Line.
What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. Miss Frances Gown is from Bomba Teller. This is Johnny Olson speaking. Tonight's program was pre-recorded. What's My Line was brought to you by soft Blue Bonnet margarine. Low in saturated fat, and everything's better with Blue Bonnet on it.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on, push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's gonna be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on, push the button.
Please subscribe.
Subscribe.
I hope they're watching.